Morning, everybody. Sorry, I laughed there because I felt a little bit uneasy on the fact that most of you are that side. I felt my balance go a bit. Which is odd how our brains work like that, right? Welcome you all this morning to our service of Holy Communion. We do have some sad news to start off the service, I'm afraid. Arthur Farndon passed away on Friday. I know there are a few in this room who will know Arthur, and so we pray for his family and his friends at this time. Father God, I hope you bring all your love and your grace to the lives of Arthur's family and friends. I pray that you give them strength and courage to go on in the days ahead and to turn to those here at St. James and all in their community to fill them with hope and grace. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And so I speak today and welcome you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. We pray together a prayer of preparation. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us sing our first song, Ye Servants of God. Pardon? Praise my soul. If you are able to, please remain standing for our confession. We come to God as from one whom no secrets are hidden, to ask for his forgiveness and peace. And so we say together, Most merciful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, we confess that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbours as ourselves. In your mercy, forgive what we have been. Help us to amend what we are, and direct what we shall be, that we may do justly, love mercy, and walk humbly with you, our God. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let's join our voices together to sing the Gloria. Please be seated. Almighty and everlasting God, increase in us your gift of faith, that, forsaking what lies behind and reaching out to that which is before, we may run the way of your commandments and win the crown of everlasting joy. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We're now going to hear our first reading.
The first reading is taken from Esther, chapter 7. So the king and Haman went in to feast with Queen Esther. On the second day, as they were drinking wine, the king again said to Esther, "What is your petition, Queen Esther? It shall be granted to you. And what is your request? Even to the half of my kingdom it shall be fulfilled." Then Queen Esther answered, "If I have won your favor, O king, and if it pleases the king, let my life be given me, that is my petition, and the lives of my people, that is my request. For we have been sold, I and my people, to be destroyed, to be killed, and to be annihilated. If we had been sold merely as slaves, men and women, I would have held my peace, but no enemy can compensate for this damage to the king." Then King Ahasuerus said to Queen Esther, "Who is he, and where is he? Who has presumed to do this?" Esther said, "A foe and enemy, this wicked Haman." Then Haman was terrified before the king and the queen. Then Harbona, one of the eunuchs in attendance on the king, said, "Look, the very gallows that Haman has prepared for Mordechai, whose word saved the king, stands at Haman's house, 50 cubits high." And the king said, hang him on that. So they hanged Haman on the gallows that he had prepared for Mordechai. Then the anger of the king abated. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The second reading is taken from James chapter 5. Are any among you suffering? They should pray. Are any cheerful? They should sing songs of praise. Are any of you among you sick? They should call for the elders of the church and have them pray over them, anointing them with oil in the name of the Lord. The prayer of faith will save the sick, and the Lord will raise them up, and anyone who has committed sins will be forgiven. Therefore, confess your sins to one another and pray for one another so that you may be healed. The prayer of the righteous is powerful and effective. Elijah was a human being like us, and he prayed fervently that it might not rain, and for 3 years and 6 months it did not rain on the earth. Then he prayed again, and the heaven gave rain, and the earth yielded its harvest. My brothers and sisters, if anyone among you wanders from the truth and is brought back by another, you should know that whoever brings back a sinner from wandering will save the sinner's soul from death and will cover a multitude of sins. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thank you, Rachel. Let us stand to sing our gospel hymn, Jesus, Where Thy People Meet. Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Mark. John said to him, "Teacher, we saw someone casting out demons in your name, and we tried to stop him because he was not following us." But Jesus said, "Do not stop him, for no one who does a deed of power in my name will be able soon afterwards to speak evil of me. Whoever is not against us is for us. For truly I tell you, whoever gives you a cup of water to drink because you bear the name of Christ will by no means lose the reward. If any of you put a stumbling block before one of these little ones who believe in me, it would be better for you if a great millstone were hung around your neck and you were thrown into the sea. If your hand causes you to stumble, cut it off. It is better for you to enter life maimed than to have two hands and go to hell, to the unquenchable fire. And if your foot causes you to stumble, cut it off. It is better for you to enter life lame than to have two feet and be thrown into hell. And if your eye causes you to stumble, tear it out. It is better for you to enter the kingdom of God with one eye than to have two eyes and to be thrown into hell, where their worm never dies and fire is never quenched. For everyone will be salted with fire. Salt is good, but if salt has lost its saltiness, how can you season it? Have salt in yourselves and be at peace with one another. This is the gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. I pray that you speak in the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. I really love our scripture from James today. And you'll hear me say that a lot. I really love this scripture because I really do love quite a lot of scripture, which is probably a good thing for my position, right? But I really do like what is said to us in the scripture today, because what's really being emphasized is that our lives should be centered on prayer in all aspects of life, both individually and communally. So whether we're praying at home on our own, or whether we're praying together in church out loud as a group, or in small little groups of two or more. Jesus said, "When two or more are gathered and worshipping my name, then I will be there." When we meet together in prayer, we are taking up that promise of Jesus being present, of Jesus being with us and listening to our prayers. Now, we know not all prayers can be answered. We don't know why, but some don't, which is why it's important that we pray all the time. Some of us, myself included, go long periods without prayer. We get to some big moments and we think, "Oh, I'm going to pray for this," and then the prayer doesn't get answered. And then we're left wondering, well, why didn't that prayer get answered? And the problem is if you do that 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 times, and each time your prayer gets unanswered, you're going to start wondering, will any of my prayers be answered? But when we pray all the time, when we pray continually, when we're constantly giving ourselves up to God, when we're confessing what we've done to him and to those of us around us and asking for their prayer as well as praying ourselves, you'll find that so much more prayer is answered. I can think of a handful of times in my own life when I've really been down and I've put my heart and my soul and my mind into prayer, and a coincidence has happened. I think I said to you a few months ago, there was I can't remember the archbishop it was, but he said, when I pray, coincidences happen, and when I don't pray, they don't happen. And I think there's something quite powerful in that when we turn to God, when we ask for things that we need, when we ask for his healing hand, quite often than not, we are given that. But it might not be in ways that you recognize. And that's the other really important part when praying with people, is hearing the words that leave their mouth and understanding that God is going to speak to us differently. God's going to speak to us in different ways. And we're going to understand that in different ways. And so when we center our lives around this prayer, when we center on ourselves being in communion with God, and when we do that with other people, we recognize that God speaks to us in a multitude and varying ways. Some people pray in this room in tongue. Some people have visions. Some people have dreams. The Spirit speaks to us in ways that some of us find weird and we don't understand what's going on there. If you were to go to my friend's Pentecostal church like I first did, I'm sure some of you would be stood there with your mouths wide open, because what have you just walked into? But then if they walked into this church, they would probably be doing the same thing. For us, it's about understanding how God communicates with us. It's about understanding how we can communicate with God. This passage emphasizes our need and our goal to pray with one another. But when do we pray with one another? We come to church and we pray intercessions. Somebody comes to the front and leads us in our prayers for the world and for our community. And we all say a responsory line. And sometimes when we're at home, we may pray to the Lord at bedtime or night, maybe with our partner. But when do we find the time to gather with people of our community and pray with them? I'm going to ask you all in a moment to pray with one another. Now, I think I've caught most of you before you came into the service to give you a bit of a warning that I would do this. For those that I didn't manage to catch, I do apologize, and I will try better next time. I'd like you all to, in a moment, turn to one another. I'd like you to say a word or a phrase that's on your mind. It might be incredibly joyful. It might be really sad. Whatever you choose is perfectly acceptable. And then I want the person who you're with, it might be three people, I'm going to find someone who's on their own in the room and pray with them too, because I would like to join in with this prayer. And you can either pray silently or out loud. And if you'd like to pray silently, I want you to hold your hands together like that, so the person you're with isn't waiting 5 minutes for you to pray. And prayer can be as simple as saying, Father God, please help this person. Say their name, say the thing that they've asked for prayer for. That is just as good as any long flowing prayer that you might hear someone say. You can also just pray the Lord's Prayer. Jesus said to us when we are in need of something to pray, pray the Lord's Prayer. And Jesus knew a thing or two about praying. Jesus often went off to pray. All throughout Scripture, we have littered verses where Jesus prays with the disciples, but then also says to them, guys, I need to go off and I need to speak with God. Even Jesus is going to speak with God. And so I'd like you to turn to the person next to you, and like I say, just say a word or a phrase, as much or as little as you want. Pray silently or out loud. Say as little or as much as you want. God will hear it all, and hopefully will answer some of them. Let us begin.
you haven't done so, pray for the other person. Let's begin to bring our thoughts and our minds back into the room. Let's end in some prayer. Father God, as you send your Holy Spirit into this world, as it mingles with the hearts, the minds, the bodies and souls of all your faithful followers in this room, lift up their prayers to you. Bring them hope, bring them grace, and bring them love. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. If you're able to, please stand as we declare our faith in God. And so we say together, we believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. We believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Please be seated for our intercessions.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, in these times of unrest and uncertainty, we pray for the Church throughout the world as she reaches out to people in distress and hardship. We pray that the Holy Spirit will strengthen us to love and serve our neighbors in Christ. We continue to pray for the Ukraine and for peace in all the world. We pray that weapons of destruction will be replaced by God's peace, that lies and deceit will be replaced by truth and integrity, that doubt and oppression will be overcome by faith and salvation. We pray for all those affected by the recent riots in our own country, and especially for the families of the three girls who were so tragically and needlessly taken from them. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, we pray for our community, our families, friends and neighbours, and especially those living in Mill Lane, Mill Pond Way, Milner Close and Moorland Close. We pray for the staff and students of St James Church of England Academy and Arden Forest School in their new school term. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, we pray for our clergy, Charles, Rob and Emma, our wardens and all the volunteers who help the running of St. James and St. Botolph's. We thank you for our church family and for the fellowship we are part of which plays an important part in our lives. Let us always have the grace to look out for one another and to be there for those who need help or a shoulder to cry on or just a simple hug. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, we pray for all those who are weakened and distressed by illness of body, mind, or spirit, and pray that your love will be heard in the darkest places of suffering. We pray today for Paul Towers, Josie Bayless, Sheila Pike, June Quinney, Carol Cross, Kerry, Gareth, Rachel G, Amanda, David, Bill Hackett, Etta Pitchford, Lissy Steele, Geraldine, and Jean Adams. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, we pray for the bereaved and all those whose anniversary is at this time. We pray especially for the family and friends of Pam Aldrich, Terry Lee, Jonathan Downs, Keith Pike, Roy Armitage, Mandy Jones, Terry Strong, Arthur Farndon, and Helen Gilkes. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, we thank you for everything you give us every day. Let us always recognize and appreciate the simple joys that come to us and not take anything for granted. Free us from worry and fill our hearts with hope, confidence, and peace. And let us be there for one another, always. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
The peace of Christ surpasses all understanding. Let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, since as members of one body you are called to peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Let us offer one another a sign of that peace.
Lord is here. Lift up your hearts.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, you made the world and love your creation. You gave your Son, Jesus Christ, to be our Saviour. His dying and rising has set us free from sin and death, and so we gladly thank you, with saints and angels praising you and singing. Praise and bless you, loving Father, through Jesus Christ our Lord, and as we obey his command, send your Holy Spirit, the broken bread and wine outpoured, may be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. On the night before he died, he had supper with his friends, and taking bread, he praised you. He broke the bread and gave it to them, and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When supper was ended, he took the cup of wine. Again he praised you, gave it to them, and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." So, Father, we remember all that Jesus did. In him we plead with confidence his sacrifice made once for all upon the cross, bringing before you the bread of life and cup of salvation. We proclaim his death and resurrection until he comes in glory. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Lord of all life, help us to work together for that day when your kingdom comes, and justice and mercy will be seen in all the earth. Look with favour on your people. Gather us in your loving arms and bring us with all the saints to feast at your table in heaven. Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory are yours, O loving Father, forever and ever. Amen. Let us be seated as we say the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body because we all share in one bread.
Christ is shed for you. Thank you.
All are welcome to receive communion today. If you would prefer a blessing, please keep your hands down by your front or your sides. If you would like to receive communion where you're seated, please let one of our stewards know, and we'll be happy to come to you at the end of the service. If you're joining the service online, I suggest to you all to pray the prayer of spiritual communion at the bottom of page 17. Come to this table not because you must, but because you may. Not because you are strong, but because you are weak. Not because you have arrived, but because you are still on a journey. Come because you love the Lord a little and want to love him more. Above all, come because he loves you and gave himself for you.
Thank you.
praise and thank you, O Christ, for this sacred feast. For here we receive you. Here the memory of your passion is renewed. Here our minds are filled with grace. And here a pledge of future glory is given, when we shall feast at that table where you reign with all your saints forever. And so we say together, Almighty God, thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. If you're able to, please stand for our final hymn, Lord of All Hopeful. Before we end our service today, just some short notices. We have our coffee morning on the 5th of October. We've got quite a few members of the team away. So if you can donate your time or if you can bake a cake, that would be wonderful. Please speak to myself, Charles, or Elizabeth. Thank you, Elizabeth. We also have our harvest fish and chips supper and quiz on Saturday the 19th of October at 7 p.m. That is going to be a free event to come along to, but you do have to bring your own drinks. And if you'd like to come, please do let Sue know. I believe there's the form at the back or a list that you can write your name on, as we do need numbers for the caterers. So if you could put your name on there, if you'd like to come, please do. It should be a really great night. I think that's everything for this week to announce, unless there's anything extra that somebody would like to pipe up? No? We're all good? Amazing. Well, let's end our wonderful service with a blessing. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen. Amen.